Welcome to H2K Infosys. H2K Infosys is a e-verify business based in Atlanta, Georgia, United States. We provide 100% job-oriented, instructor-led, face-to-face, true live online software training programs. It also includes access to cloud test lab with software tools. We provide live project for you to work on. We also provide assistance with mock interviews, resume preparation and review, and job placement assistance. H2K Infosys is trusted by so many students across the world. H2K Infosys provides world-class services in IT training with real-time project work for corporates and individuals, special IT training for MS students in the United States, software design, development, QA manual and automation, performance testing and maintenance, IT staff augmentation, job placement assistance and tech support.
Test failure. Okay. And then on final test failure, what to do? If all the tests fails, okay, I'm trying to rerun again and again, even then it has failed. So this is for automated test run. Look at this, okay, you can read it and understand. If an automated test fails, rerun up to how many times? Then on the final failure of any test set, what you want the quality center to do? Do nothing. Okay. Stop the test set. Okay. Rerun the test set. You have three options. Select one of them. You want to stop, stop it. You want to rerun it, rerun it. For how many times you mention this? Okay. You want do nothing, do nothing. Whatever you say, your quality center will follow. Okay. Notifications here. Let's say, look at these again. Okay. You can read this. And then, you know, it is very much clear. Send an email. Okay. There are three conditions. Test in the execution dialog box is failed. Now tell me whom are you going to send this email to if I check this in case it is failed. Whom are you going to send? Developer. So whose email ID are you going to write here? Developer's email ID, right? Okay. So what is this first condition? In case the test cases are failing, okay, check this box and give the email ID of your developer here. You want any message you can mention. Automatically quality center will send a message to him. Clear? Okay, next thing. In case of environmental problem, failure, network problem, hardware failure, whom are you going to inform? Exactly. Your system admin. Okay, then. If all the tests have failed, passed successfully and they have finished, this time whom are you going to inform? Very good. You inform your team lead that you have completed everything successfully. That's it. Clear? Is it difficult or easy? See, just read it a bit and you can explore the things on your own. Okay, so I've covered all of them. Link defect. This one I will show you. Linking I will show you. Okay. Then defect I have shown you. Is it clear? See, requirement I finished, test plan, test lab, defect. Just 10 minutes and you know we can learn this quality center so quickly. I mean, if we start, okay, 1 hour or 2 hour, really, okay, trust me. If you take this tool, 1 hour, 2 hour is sufficient to explore this one. Okay. Yes, on failure is for automation, Divya. Is it clear, everybody? Okay. Then. Okay, I'll come to this list. Okay. One more new thing we will learn. That is, you know, most important thing. Linking we will learn and then we will learn reporting. Okay. Then I will come to your system and I'll check what is the problem. Okay. Fine. So now the next thing is what? Linking. Okay. What to link and why to link. Tell me why should we do the linking? We have learned the requirement traceability matrix, if you remember. The purpose of the requirement traceability matrix is same as the linking that is present in the quality center. If you have the Excel sheet, we write the RTM. If it is like quality center, we do the linking. Now you got to tell me what is the purpose of linking. Yes. Very good. Sarita, mapping. Yes. What else? Traceability. Yes. Very good. Follow up with the requirements. Yes. To trace back to the requirement. Very good. Yes, see, you know the answer, okay? Okay, so why are we going to do the linking? And first of all, let's see what are we going to link. So we have the requirement over here. Then we have the test case over here. We have the defect, okay? So we can link all of them. Okay, we can link requirement, test case, defect, all of them together, correct? What is the purpose of this? Yes, to trace. Now if I see the test case, I can tell, okay, to which requirement I have written that test case. If I see that test case, I can find out what are the defects that are present in that test case, correct? If I see the defect, I can understand this defect is from which test case, which requirement, correct? This is the traceability, okay? And also the mapping. The traceability, and for the mapping, we are going to do the linking. Purpose is clear? Yes, Vidya, also to have a record. That is also true. So shall I show you how to do the linking? Ready everyone? Okay. Yeah. So we have the requirements over here. No, Anita, sit quiet and listen now, okay? You have 3 days weekend and you can relax, okay? Now you have to listen to me. See, we have the requirements, we have the link defects. Okay. Do you see we have the requirement coverage and then we have the link defects. Alright. Okay. So now what we can do is I can link the test case to the requirement and also to the link defects. Okay. Anita, you didn't mind, right? I said you got to listen. Okay. I hope you didn't mind. See, now I'm into the test plan module wherein I have the test cases. So this I got to link with the requirement and I can link with the defects. Is it clear? Okay, see, I have a test case over here. I can link it to the requirement coverage and also to the link defects. So if I go to the requirement coverage, it's going to link to the requirements. If I go to the link defects, it can link to the defects. Clear everybody? Thanks, Anita. Anita is very good. Okay. Test case, we can link it to the requirements using requirement coverage. We can link it to the link defects using the defects module. Is this clear, everyone? Shall I show how to link? Okay, it is quite simple. Okay, see here. So first I click here, requirement. Okay, somebody wanted for Bank of America, right? Okay, where is Bank of America? Yeah, it is here. Thank you. Okay. So now I have selected the test case and I have seen some people, okay, what they do is they click on this Bank of America and they start asking me where is that link tab. See here, you got to click on the test case here, then only all these tabs will be visible. Okay. I mean, this has happened in my previous batch, so I'm just telling you here. Okay. Some people, what they do, they just click here, Bank of America, and they give me a call. I'm not able to see the tabs in my quality center. See here, you got to click on the test case here. Then only all these things will be visible. Okay. Make sure you click that. Okay. Now, first, I will show you how to link the requirements. We have a requirement coverage here. Do you see a button here, select requirement? Yes. Okay. Shall I click? Okay. Look here. When I click, do you see the list of requirements here which are appearing? These are nothing but the same requirements that you had created in the requirement module. Okay. This is not something that is, you know, the quality center is doing the magic, but the requirements that you had created in the requirement module are appearing over here. Correct? Then what you should do? where is your online banking? Yeah, it is here. Okay, so do you see there is account summary? Now I want to link this account summary test case. Okay, so this is your account summary test case which is present in your test plan module, and this is the list of requirements that is present here in your requirement module. Account summary is here. I'm going to link both of them here. How do I link? Simply select and click on this button. Okay, see, select the account summary, click on this button. This is it, over. Okay, so whichever test case you want, you select it. Okay, you have the account summary here. Okay, select this account summary, click on this. Okay, see here, I'm linking these both. No, Anita, we are not in the test lab. See here, we are in our test plan, wherein this is a test case. Account summary is a test case. This account summary is what? This is a requirement. Okay, so this is requirement, this is test case. I'm linking this both. You should not link like that, Vinaya. Why you link one test case with another requirement? You should not do like that, right? Oh, by mistake if you do, do you see there is a delete button? Yes, delete it. Okay, clear everybody? How to link? Okay, now you got to tell me how to link the requirements with the defect. Now you got to tell me how to link the defect with the requirement. Okay, Vidya has the first step. Let me write your steps first. Okay, now you have to tell me how I should link it. Okay, yes, tell me what is the first step. I should go to the linked defect module. Correct. Then what? Then I have to check here somewhere, okay. There will be some option here wherein, you know, I can select the defect from. For example, I clicked on the select requirements and then the list of requirements appeared. Similarly, I will have somewhere over here wherein, you know, I'll be selecting the defects. Then I select the defect, link it. Clear? Let's see. Link defect is there. Let's check these one by one. So what is this? It is delete button. Oh, new defect, sorry. I don't want new defect. There is some plus sign over here. Okay, do you see link existing defect? Let me explore this one, okay. Click on the small arrow mark. There are two options. By ID, select. We will see both of them, okay. Let's try out the ID first. Click on by ID. Defect ID is there, correct? Anybody remembers the defect ID? We had marked the account summary when defect we marked, right? Anybody remembers? 45 or 49? I'm getting two answers. 45 or 49? Okay, whatever. See, if you remember it, enter it directly 49 or 45 and click on link. It is 49, not 45. Okay. See, there are possibilities, right? You might forget the defect ID. Correct? Some of you said 49, some of you said 45. Means there are chances that you forget the defect ID. Very clear. Okay, it is proved. Now what I do? So that's why, go for the select. If you do not remember the defect ID, go for select. See here, the list of defects are there. Now I can find out which is the defect I want to link. Do you see? Here it is. 49 is the correct one. Okay. Select the defect which you want to link. Click on the link. It is already linked, it is saying. Okay, because we have linked it, right? This is how you link it. Clear everybody? Two options. If you are remembering the defect ID, enter it directly, or you can select from the list. Is it clear? If delete...
So many of our students have given testimonials on how our training programs are. You will find them on kudzu.com and on our website h2kinfosys.com. On our website h2kinfosys.com, you will also find more detailed information on who we are, the courses that we offer, what each course covers. Also, if you're interested in a demo program, please register on our homepage on the left-hand side. Just give us more information about yourself and we will send you a link for a demo class. The demo class is absolutely free. Experience our commitment by just attending an orientation workshop at no cost. Our team of faculty and advisors are here to guide you with the right information. If you still have more questions, please feel free to call us. Call us at 770-777-1269. This is a United States number. If you're calling from the UK, call us at 020-337-17615. You can also email us at training@h2kinfosys.com or h2kinfosys@gmail.com. Thank you for watching our videos. We wish you a great career in information technology.